Yo, what's good everyone? Today we are back with another brand new game. This one is called Cabin Crew Simulator. Funny story about this game, I actually went ahead and played their previous version of it last year, thanks to one of my longtime subscribers here on the channel by the name of Dylan. And most recently, I think roughly around, I want to say like 5, maybe 7 days ago, they went ahead and released their final finished product. So we're going to be checking it out in today's video, seeing how far along we can actually make it. The whole entire concept of the game is that you're starting your own airline and you basically go ahead and control literally everything. So you're kind of like the flight attendant. You get on the plane, travel across to wherever your destination is going to be, serve food to people, and basically get everybody ready for their flight. It's super cool, but let's go ahead and get into this. Hello, welcome to Cabin Crew. Before creating a flight, check out the game's catalog to get into proper style. Now, like I said, I was an alpha tester, so I'm assuming I got some sort of perk here. It says, thank you, we appreciate you being a tester for Cabin Crew Alpha. For your involvement, enjoy a starting bonus of 4,000 skybucks and a special page in the catalog. So that's pretty cool. Before we go any further into this, please, if you guys are new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe. Drop a like on the video if you do end up enjoying it. And also, let me know if you guys want to see some more videos on Cabin Crew Simulator. Once you guys see how detailed it is and how much there is to actually do, I think some of you will really enjoy it, especially those of you that for a really long time have asked me to go ahead and play games like Flight Simulator and all of that. But anyways, if we go ahead and turn around here, you'll notice there's a couple of outfits that we can go ahead and basically get ourselves into so we can, I guess, immerse ourselves. So obviously you have the basic male and the basic female outfit. These are completely free, and then there's other ones that you can go ahead and purchase for in-game currency. Personally, at the very start, I would say that it's not very smart to go ahead and buy any of these because you're going to need this money in order to go ahead and upgrade your planes, as well as make a bunch of different upgrades for your airline service. But let me check out really quick here what the alpha perks are. Ooh, so everything inside of here is actually free. Got a vintage wing pin, bunch of different pins, reflective hats, some suitcases. Oh, dude, this is pretty cool. Now, I don't really think I'm gonna switch into anything. Maybe we'll switch into the basic male outfit, just because that one is free. And actually, now that I think about it, I always forget that the headless horseman outfit doesn't actually let me do that. So we're just gonna pretend that never happened. But anyways, it says, walk to the flight display and click it to select and create your flight. We're gonna walk up to here. Create flight, and right here we have Carbon Meisters Airline. Right now the quality is not that great. We have some good service and some good safety, but unfortunately we're only rated at 3.5 stars. Our goal here is going to be to get to 5-star rating. So let's see, what is our first destination here? So we get to customize our plane. That's pretty cool. And then down here we have a bunch of different other planes that we can purchase. I'm assuming they get bigger, and of course we can fit a lot more customers inside of here. So let's see, how big does this get? An A330-200 for 19,000. Whoa. Well, currently I can fit a total of 11 passengers, 0 multiplayer. So I'm assuming if I wanted to, I could go ahead and get some of you on the plane. And then we have no business class. I do have 4,000 to start off with. So maybe we should kind of jump right over to the next one. So the next plane will upgrade us to 16 passengers. And instead of earning 400 skybucks, we can earn 525. That is very interesting. Okay. Unfortunately, we do have to go in order of purchase. So I can't really kind of like skip over to this one if I wanted to, because it's locked. I need to go ahead and purchase every single one before. Kind of good, because it doesn't let you pay to win all the way to the end. But let's go ahead and skip doing this. I want to kind of just get the feel and understanding, because like I said, they've made a lot of changes to this game since the last time that I played this. So we're going to select that. And then here we get to choose our destination. So we have two options right now, New York City or Seattle. Personally, I think I'm gonna go for New York City. It's a longer flight and it's gonna give me more time to really understand all of the tasks that we need to do inside of our plane. So we're gonna select New York City, and then here we get to select the menu. So for economy, I think we're gonna keep it chips, nut mix, and cookies, just not to overcomplicate things. And for beverages, we have water, coffee, and Coca-Cola. Personally, not a fan of Coca-Cola, so I'm going to throw in some Pepsi in there. And then obviously we don't have any business or first class on our plane, so we'll go ahead and move on now. Now it says your flight was successfully created. Walk through security and look at the departure flight board to locate your gate. This is super cool, dude. I seriously love this game. The last time I played it, I want to say that the last time I played it was October of last year. So it has been an entire year now. Okay, so here we go. Departures. We have New York City, airline,
Carbonmeister's Airline Flight 3736.
And then it says status on time, and we are going to gate number 3. So where is this going to be? Right over there, up ahead. It says, once you're ready, walk into the jetway to get into your aircraft and start boarding. So these are all of our customers that are going to be getting on. So let's jump on the plane ourselves first. We can basically be waiting for everybody already inside of the plane. My character is huge inside of here, so this is going to be kind of interesting. It's probably going to be a little uncomfortable to do things. But let's see, we have a little panel here and it says departure, cruising, arrival. Expand screen. We got lighting, safety info, boarding music, prepare cabin for departure. Okay, I guess for the sake of right now, we'll just go ahead and do it without audio, and I'll get confirmation from the developers if I get a chance. And then if we do a follow-up video, I'll turn on the audio that time. Anyways, let's go ahead and start boarding. We're going to start getting all of our customers walking in here in a second. I'm just going to go ahead and stand here off to the side so that way we make enough room for everybody to go ahead and jump on and take their seats. All right, here we go. Welcome to Carbonmeister Airline. I appreciate you guys. Hopefully this is going to be a good flight and we're not going to run into any issues. That's another thing, actually. I don't know if they kept this inside of their actual game from the last time that I played it, but there was different things that could happen, like turbulence. I think even fires were able to happen. It's kind of crazy. I don't know what we're going to experience, but let's see. It says the passengers with an orange exclamation mark are not ready for departure. See what they're not doing right and interact with the passenger to make sure they are all set up. All right, so let's go ahead and walk down here. All right, so let's see. Their luggage is still open over here, so we're going to close that. And then we're going to interact with them and see what else. Can you bring your seat upright? It seems like their seat is upright. Can you buckle your seatbelt? That's what they're missing. There we go. Sure. So that one's done. Over here, the next one, we're going to interact. And I believe it's the tray table for this one. So there we go. Next one is seatbelt over here as well. So let's do seatbelt. And now we should be good to go. All we got to do is just close this luggage over here. And now we're good. All right. So if we take a look at our little monitor over here, it says door is not closed, but passengers are all seated. Passengers have all been checked and overhead bins have been closed. Let's walk over to the door, close this, and we are ready for takeoff. It says, please be seated in order to take off. So we're going to sit up here in the front. Got our seatbelt on. Everybody is doing good. And we're going to press takeoff. Let's go. All right. So some vibrations are going on right now. This is so cool, dude. The cabin is prepared for takeoff. It's time to depart. We are now cruising. In the bottom right of your screen, you should have access to a serving cart. Open your cart, select the item they ask for, and give it to them. They will reject any item. Okay, that went too fast. You can now go to the passenger with drinks and food icons above their head and ask them what they would like to have. Okay, perfect. So we should be able to pull out our serving cart. Let's see. We're going to do economy food first. Click interact and we're going to do all of the food first and then we'll do the drinks afterwards. So what would you like to eat? They said nut mix. So there we go. Let's click on nut mix. Give it to them. Thank you very much. Dude, this is literally like being on a real flight. Interact again. What would you like to eat? Got some chips this time. There you go. What would you like to eat? Nut mix. Here you go. All right, so we got a good little system going on here. Now, obviously, after this, I need to go ahead and travel back down here so I can start handing out the drinks. And then I'm kind of curious to see what's next after that. For the most part, doesn't really seem like too many people are interested in the cookies. So that might be something that we might want to look into getting rid of for our next flight. Maybe replacing it with bagels or something. I don't know. All right. So everybody has been served their food. Now we're going to go ahead and swap our cart. So we press E again. This time we take out economy drinks. So let's see. What drink would you like? We got coffee over here. I'm really interested to see how many people order Pepsi over Coke. This is going to be very... Okay. Another coffee. All right. I guess nobody wants soda. What are you going to get? Coffee again. Are you joking? What is this, a business flight? Coca-Cola? No, dude, not Coca-Cola. You guys need to order Pepsi. There you go, Pepsi. Now we're talking. So right now, Pepsi and Coca-Cola are tied. Gonna be interesting, dude. Another coffee. What is going on? Well, coffee is definitely staying on our menu. Water. Okay. So right here, this customer doesn't have a symbol over their head. So we're gonna go ahead and skip right past them. Another Coca-Cola. No, dude. Coca-Cola's in the lead right now. Please hook your boy up with some Pepsi. Come on.
No, dude. Coca-Cola is so gassy. It's like actually terrible. It makes my stomach hurt. Let me know in the comments, what do you guys prefer, Coca-Cola or Pepsi? Nice job, you finished serving. The passengers are just finished up their drinks and snacks. It's time to collect the trash. Open the trash by clicking on the trash button and click on the trash icon for each item. Okay, so now we have trash on the bottom right hand side. Ah, there we go. All right, so we click here, click here. Dude, this is so cool. It seriously feels like you're running your own airline. They definitely have added a lot of new features and made it way more detailed, but I really want to see some interesting things going on here. Maybe some turbulence. I don't know, just some crazy stuff. All right, so there we go. All trash is collected. We're almost ready to land. Go through the passengers and make sure they are ready for landing. All right, so we got to do the same exact thing that we did before. This customer seems to be leaning back, so we got to tell her to sit upright. Over here, we got to put the tray away. What else? You're good. You're good. Put your seat upright. There we go. You're good. Everybody's good over here. Go ahead and close your tray. Sit upright and put your seatbelt on. What are you doing, man? You can't take your seatbelt off. All right. Ready for landing. Please be seated in order to land. So let's click on land. And here we go, man. We should be getting ready to land here. And then we got to go ahead and prepare everybody to get off of the airplane. This is so cool, dude. The detail is mind-blowing. All right, so it says the jetway is attaching. Once it's fully attached, you can open the boarding door and the passengers will deboard. I'm kind of messing with the buttons over here. So lighting, it looks like there's a bunch of different lightings that you can go ahead and do. That's pretty cool. I don't think I ever turned on the lighting. So that's kind of weird. There's also a custom button. Oh, this is for Robux. Okay. Anyways, it looks like it is attached right now, so we can go ahead, open up the door, and everybody is going to start getting off. Before leaving the aircraft, make sure all overhead bins have been opened and all passengers have deplaned. Oh, no, wait. Are they all open? They have been. Okay. So Robloxia to New York City. Flight quality was 1.6 out of 5. What? Flight service was 5 out of 5. Flight safety was 5 out of 5. Payment amount, $285. How do I get my quality up? Man, that's kind of a bummer. That sort of hurt my feelings. We didn't even get a 2.0 quality. Anyways, we've now gone ahead and gotten off of the airplane. We're going to make our way back to the front where you obviously need to go ahead and create your next flight. And you just pretty much rinse and repeat this. Obviously, go ahead and upgrade your airplane. You can go ahead and customize it to whatever look you want to have for it. There's just a lot of different things that you can do in this game. I think it's really cool. What is this over here? The 9 Hotel New York. What are you doing here? Can I talk to this person? How may I help you? I'd like to request a room. I'd like to check out. Goodbye. Oh, request a room. Do you like a regular or premium room? The menu is like a little difficult to click on. It kind of like disappears every now and then, but let's do a premium room. Oh, that's for Robux. Okay. Well, never mind then. Not even sure why you would want to get inside of here. Maybe sometimes there's a flight where it's a different time and you kind of have to like wait. That could be the case right there. But anyways, I'm going to show you guys really quickly the customizing. But before we do that, I do want to go ahead and upgrade to a better plane. This is going to cost us 1,000 Skybucks. Not a big deal. We got 4,000 right now. And to be honest, I kind of want to upgrade to even the one after that, which is the E175. This one is going to upgrade our max Skybucks earning to 600 and our passengers to 26. It also allows us to have one multiplayer. So that's interesting. Still, unfortunately, no business class. It doesn't look like we're going to be getting business class until the B737 for 3,750. So let's upgrade to the E175. That leaves me with $1,200. Not bad at all. Let me customize this really quickly because I don't like the yellow. I definitely want to make this more of a red. So let's go with this. Click right here. Confirm that. Change this to red as well. And this. And we'll also change the belly of the plane to red. That looks way better. Look at that. Cool. So we just went ahead and exit out of that. Now our plane is red, looking real nice. And so it looks like now we need to purchase our next flight. So obviously we're already in New York, so we can't fly back to New York. And Robloxia is not an option from what I can tell here. Oh, it is. Okay, so we can fly to Robloxia from New York if we wanted to. Or we can go ahead and use some of our money to purchase Seattle. Unfortunately, I shouldn't have made those upgrades because now I can't afford Seattle. So we're going to have to fly back to Robloxia in order to get enough money to purchase Seattle. But we got some interesting options here, man. Los Angeles, Honolulu, Tokyo, Tahiti, and Santorini. I've never heard of Santorini. Now, over here, we know for sure now that cookies are not popular. Unfortunately, I don't think we can remove them. We can only add on to this. So if that's the case, then wouldn't it be beneficial to just highlight everything that we have available? I feel like that would make the most sense to just highlight everything that we had available. So we should have had bagels and bread rolls available that last flight, and we should have had Sprite available as well. How much is ginger ale? 210. I don't really want to purchase anything right now because we obviously need that flight to Seattle. So we'll just go with what we have right now. And this is going to give us 427 Skybucks as an estimated Skybucks earnings. So that's pretty good. Definitely an upgrade from our 200 of before. But I don't think that we're gonna do another flight today. Like I always do here on the channel, man, I really just wanted to go ahead and show you guys the game for our very first video here. So if you guys are interested in seeing more on Cabin Crew Simulator, let me know in the comments. I'll definitely be interested in making more on this, especially since I want to see what happens when we end up getting business seating, because obviously those will be higher ticket customers, so we'll be making a lot more money there. And if I'm not mistaken, I think in business class you can actually like lay down and like take a nap and all that stuff, so those flights will be a lot longer, way more to do. And I'm also interested to see if in longer flights we end up getting some of those natural disasters. As always, link to the game will be in the description if you guys want to go ahead and check it out for yourself. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If so, don't forget, drop a like on it. You don't have to, but I would really appreciate it if you did. Subscribe to the channel for more on this game. But that's going to go ahead and do it for this one. Like always, I will see you guys in the next video. Take care.